The Fishhook Asterism is one of the easiest star patterns to recognize in the sky. I'll never forget the first time I saw it in its entirety. It was July of 2005. I just landed in Kona, and as I walked off the plane onto the tarmac, I looked up and immediately saw this pattern. And as I drove to my new home, I remember pressing my face up against the glass just to get another glimpse of this pattern. So in this video, we will examine how to find the star pattern, mythologies connected with it, and get lots of practice recognizing this star pattern. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky one constellation at a time. First, let's review what asterisms are, because they are not true constellations. They could either be a pattern or a group of stars that are a part of a constellation, or maybe even a collection of constellations. They are useful for people who are just starting to learn how to ID things in the night sky. So here I have a picture for you. I use this photo all the time because it has lots of constellations. But first, I want to show you what the asterisms look like. Here are some examples of asterisms that you can see in the summer sky in the northern hemisphere, such as the summer triangle, the northern cross, we have the teapot, the coat hanger asterism, and then here is Maui's hook or the fish hook. It goes by different names, and of course, like everything in science, there's multiple names for the same thing. But here, this is the lens of constellations. So these are the constellation patterns, while the asterisms are just more simple patterns. And in this video, we're focusing on the fishhook, which after all these years of living in Hawaii, I just know it as Maui's hook. You can't discuss the fishhook asterism without talking about Hawaiian and Polynesian mythology. And in this realm of the world, Scorpius is known as the fishhook of Maui, the great demigod. And there are many stories that surround this legendary folk hero. And the stories of Maui are told on the islands of Hawaii, Samoa, Tonga, New Zealand, Tahiti, and many other island nations. And there isn't enough time in this video to review all the stories. I'll share one with you in the next part of the video, but they do have similar themes. Maui is often credited with fishing the islands from the sea with his magical hook and discovering the secret to fire making that was certainly useful for humans and for capturing the sun to lengthen the days for growing food. And it's very easy to see how Polynesians visualized a hook in the sky because this constellation or asterism makes an exact shape of that. And of course, with the release of Disney's Moana movie, the legends of Maui are becoming more well known. However, it is important to remember that each Polynesian nation has their own versions of the legend. But I do love that people all over the world are getting more exposure to Polynesian culture because of this movie. One of the legends I wanted to share with you comes from Hawaii, where this star pattern is known as Maui's fishhook. And one of the stories goes that one day Maui went fishing with his brothers in their outrigger canoe, and he brought with him his magical fishhook, and he instructed his brothers that whatever he caught with it, they were to continue paddling and never look back. As Maui was fishing, he caught a huge object and asked his brothers to keep paddling harder while he pulled on the line. As he kept pulling and as his brothers kept paddling, rocks started to appear. He pulled more and more, and rocks continued to appear. And finally, he pulled hard enough that large chunks of land surfaced from the ocean. His brothers were tired, though, from all the rowing, and they were curious about what he was trying to catch. So they did look back. And one of the brothers called out, "Look, Maui is pulling up land." And furious, Maui responded, "Had you not looked back, these islands could have been a great land." So now these islands are known as Hawaii, and they're not one giant island because those islands sank back down. So there's a variety of this type of story throughout Polynesian culture, but this is one that I was familiar with that I wanted to share it with you. And I'm going to put a link down below for you to read a little bit more about this story. Now let's get some practice with how to identify the fishhook pattern in the sky. The key is looking south because that's exactly where you're going to find this star pattern. And as you're looking at this photo, take your eyes to the right side of the photograph, and I want you to start hunting for that hook-like pattern. It is somewhat close to the brightest part of the Milky Way. And if you need a little assistance with finding the fishhook, this is where it is. So it is really big in the sky as well. I think when I first saw it in Hawaii, I was like, wow, I didn't realize how big this was. And from my house where I grew up in Pennsylvania, I wasn't able to see this whole constellation. And the reason is because looking south, there is a huge mountain behind my house. So I was only able to see like the upper portion of it from where I would stargaze. There is another star pattern here. This is known as the teapot. It makes up the constellation Sagittarius. And some other asterisms are the summer triangle, which are made up by Lyra, Cygnus, and Aquila. And then here are all the constellations, or at least a majority of the main ones that are in this particular picture. And why is Scorpius so cool to look at? The reason is because there are so many different celestial objects within this star pattern. And this is part of the fun of looking at this constellation. You have the butterfly star cluster, the Ptolemy cluster, and other globular star clusters, open star clusters. It's just such a great part of the sky to look at. So let's get some more practice. Here is another photo. There are multiple star patterns here, but can you find Scorpius or the fishhook? You want to look for Antares, the brightest star in this picture. And from there, can you start to trace out the hook pattern? If we were to point out everything that's in this photo, this is what it looks like. So here, the fishhook is just so obvious to me. It's really one of the easiest patterns to see. And then some other star patterns we have, this is Libra. And then down here is Sagittarius, also known as the asterism of the teapot. So now I want to show you one more photo to just give you some more practice with recognizing this star pattern. And here is a very simple picture. And this is a little bit more realistic of what you would see in the night sky. We often do not see this because many of us don't have access to a dark sky like this where the Milky Way will come out. This is also a long exposure photograph, so some of those background stars are going to start to appear. But if you go outside, this is more likely what you're going to see. So let's see. How good are you? Are you able to point out Scorpius? I can see it. I want you to look towards the right bottom of this photograph and start to find that hook-like shape. Also, the Milky Way is appearing here. Here's the kind of brightest part of the Milky Way, and you know that the fish hook must be nearby. So here I'll just point it out for you. This is the fish hook right there. A part of Scorpius is being cut off a little bit, but really we're seeing the fishhook asterism, and that's what I want you to see. This is where Antares is, that bright reddish colored star. So we've come to the end of our video about the fishhook asterism. Also, it looks just like the Scorpius, the scorpion pattern as well. And it's best seen in June, July, August, September. This range of time that you can see it does depend on what your latitude is. And you can see it during the summertime in the northern hemisphere, and this would be the wintertime for the southern hemisphere. And you can see it from both hemispheres. Actually, if you live in the southern hemisphere, you have a better chance of seeing it. However, lots of people in the northern hemisphere can see it as well. Just anybody above 40 degrees north will start to struggle to see this. And the way to find it is simply look for the giant hook pattern when looking south. You can also help orient yourself by trying to find Antares, this bright reddish colored star that really stands out. So I hope this video was helpful for you in learning how to identify the fish hook pattern. And let me know in the comments below, are you able to see this from your part of the world? Do you remember the first time you ever saw it? I mean, for me, it was like just one of those memories cemented in my brain, like, oh my God, that is a huge star pattern. And I can actually see the whole thing for once. So I hope you have an experience like that in your stargazing journey as well. So thank you so much for watching. I appreciate your comments and support. And remember, keep going outside. Try to seek out dark skies. Take a friend. friend or pet with you. And as always, keep looking up.